Welcome. In this video, we create and define a basic theme called simplesmart. In doing so, we'll learn about the required keys of a theme and how to make our theme compatible with specific versions of Drupal core. Let's do this. The first thing we need to do is make sure that you have your project loaded in a code editor. For this course, I'll be using Sublime Text, but you can and should use whatever code editor you are more comfortable with. Follow along, and once you have your Drupal project site loaded in your editor, we need to create a directory in the correct place for a custom theme. In the themes directory, at your webroot, then within themes, custom, create a new directory called simplesmart. If you do not yet have a custom directory within the themes directory, go ahead and create it first before creating the simplesmart directory. Having a directory named custom where you will place your custom themes is best practice. Real quick, I want to highlight that the name you choose for your theme is important. To avoid confusion and headaches in the future, it's recommended that you choose a name that is unique to Drupal. A straightforward check you can apply is to open your web browser and visit your desired name after drupal.org/project/. So, for example, let's test our desired name of simplesmart. In the URL, I'll type out drupal.org/project/simplesmart. Hit enter to visit. Seeing this 404 error from the browser means that this name of simplesmart is not currently in use. For comparison, let's check the name of simple. In the browser, type drupal.org/project/simple, hit enter, and sure enough, we can see that the name of simple is currently in use. This means that using simple as the name of our theme is not advisable. Let's stick with simplesmart as our theme name and head back over to our code editor. With your code editor open, in the simplesmart directory, create a new file called simplesmart.info.yml, simplesmart.info.yaml. All custom theming starts by telling Drupal the basic information it needs to know about your new theme. In Drupal, this is done by creating a .info.yml file, which tells Drupal that your theme exists and how to access its assets. Recall that a theme has two names, the machine name and the human readable name. The machine name is set from the name of your info.yaml file and the name of your theme's directory. So in our case, the machine name of our theme is simplesmart, one word with all lowercase letters. The human readable name is set within the info.yaml file. So within this simplesmart.info.yaml file, place the name key by typing name colon space and the human readable name simplesmart classy version as the human readable name of your theme. Remember that this is a YAML file, and so any text you type here must adhere to the YAML syntax. For example, if you wish to use an ampersand character, you would need to escape it or wrap the entire string within quotation marks. Okay, let's look at the following required keys of this info.yaml file. Drupal requires a few keys to be present in an info.yaml file for it to recognize that this collection of files is actually a theme. We have already entered the name key. The other required keys are type, core version requirement, core, and base theme. These keys are required, so let's complete them now. With type, enter theme. We need to distinguish between themes and modules as Drupal uses an info.yaml file to define both. The keys of core version requirement and core tell Drupal which versions of Drupal core this theme is compatible with. If we want our theme to be compatible with Drupal core version 8.7.7 and earlier versions of Drupal 8, then we need to have this core key. The key of core version requirement was added after core version 8.7.7, and this key supports semantic versioning as implemented by the Composer project. If you have this core version requirements key, then this core key is technically optional. However, for the sake of completeness, let's leave both of these keys in. For core version requirement, we need to use semantic versioning syntax. To make this theme compatible with Drupal 8 and Drupal 9, type caret 8 space pipe pipe space caret 9. This is effectively saying any version of Drupal 8 or Drupal 9 is compatible with this theme. But let's not forget that versions of Drupal 8.7.7 will not recognize this core versions requirement key. So for that, we need to enter 8.x for the core key to make this theme truly compatible with all versions of Drupal 8 and Drupal 9. The remaining required key of this file is base theme. We'll learn more about base themes later on in this course, but for now, type classy, C-L-A-S-S-Y. Classy is a theme historically provided by Drupal Core. Classy is the base theme used by Bartik and Seven. Classy itself is a sub-theme of Stable that adds many helpful classes that make it easier to quickly achieve a modern look with Drupal. Pause briefly and see if you can identify other keys which are currently not present in our Simple Smart theme. Okay, although there are many additional keys we could put here, one common key that is not currently present because it is not required is the description key. Let's type this out now. Although you could put the description key on its own line anywhere you wish, I prefer to type it just below the type key for readability. Type description colon space, then double quotes, a sleek ampersand practical theme for curious minds. Notice that this text is wrapped with double quotes. This is because of the ampersand is a special character within YAML. And this is a good way for us to practice handling special characters with these double quotes. Make sure that it begins with double quotes and ends with double quotes. A sleek and practical theme for curious minds. Awesome. Now that we have defined our simple smart theme, make sure to save this file and let's head over to our site to test it out. Go ahead and open up your site in your browser. Once you have brought your local Drupal site up in your browser, in the admin menu, click on Appearance to see our list of themes. Currently for me, Bartik is the default theme. So if we scroll down to the uninstalled themes, we'll encounter our Simple Smart Classy version theme. Right now, it is showing a default screenshot, and we'll learn how to change this in an upcoming video. For now, let's click on Install and Set as Default to activate the Simple Smart theme. Before we click Install and Set as Default though, let's try to anticipate what we will encounter after we do. Remember, at this point, we have only defined the info.yaml file for the Simple Smart theme. Will we see nothing? Will we encounter errors? Take a moment to anticipate what will happen. When you're ready, click on Install and Set as Default. Great! The appearance did not change for me, but that is because we are viewing an admin page, which has a different theme from the default theme. To view the Simple Smart theme, we need to visit a front-end page. So, I'll click on the home breadcrumb link here, and wow! Pure Drupal output! No errors! Our theme isn't doing much at all, and at this point is just using Drupal default theme settings. Any HTML rendered is default from Drupal. Let's check out what regions are available for our Simple Smart theme. Remember, we defined no regions in our info.yaml file. To view the regions, in the admin menu, click on Structure, then Block Layout. Make sure that you are viewing the blocks for Simple Smart Classy version, and then click on Demonstrate Block Regions. Awesome! As you can tell, these 10 regions are provided by default from Drupal. Enabling our Simple Smart theme with no settings is a strong reinforcement that theming in Drupal is really about overriding the default output of Drupal. Head back home if you wish. Nice work completing this video and for starting your simple smart theme. Take a break if you need to, and I'll see you in upcoming videos. Happy learning! Mm-hmm.